probably like run into this forest and disappear like a second.
Okay, ready, Jonathan? I'll time you. Ready? Set, go!
During the Holocaust, there were Jews who fought back against their oppressors called the Partisans, who were armed resistors behind enemy lines. And my grandfather was a Partisan. Him and his brothers helped save 400 Jews. They took it upon themselves to go out into the woods to fight, and they survived the Holocaust.
21 seconds, you disappeared!
Obviously, you don't want to be in that situation where you're running away from someone, but if I had to run away from someone, I think this would be the best place to do it in.
My grandfather did many things in the forest. He built bunkers, kind of like underground camps, and they took a stand.
I want to be a bunker. Come on, I want to show you.
Kick it up, and I'll kick
the rest.
Yeah, kick it up. And I'll kick
that up. What do you think?
Might be a bunker under here.
No, it's nothing. It's not a bunker.
My youngest son, Izzy, his bar mitzvah is coming up and he's studying it for it, and he's asking questions about the people that might not be there, or that can't be there, which include my parents, my father Isidore and my mother Julia. And he wants to know about them and their history and their heritage. So what he's asked to do is to actually go back to Poland and the Ukraine.
I think it's crazy how my grandfather took my dad to Poland and Ukraine, where he grew up and where he fought as a partisan in World War II. And now my dad's taking me and Jonathan on the very same trip, and I just can't wait.
This is my father, Isidore. This is his. I hope from this trip, my children should be able to identify with Holocaust survivors and their losses. I think that's important for them to carry on the legacy. Even myself thought that my father's stories and my mother's stories, they were, you know, that they came from a stone. They didn't realize there were actual villages with neighbors who know them and can talk about them and tell me about my grandparents.
Karten says, "E, Isidore."
Isidore.
I've seen many pictures and videos of my grandfather, the mill that my great-grandfather ran, the house that he lived in, the barn where he escaped from the back door. I've seen many, many pictures. What I really want to see, though, is my great-grandmother's grave.
I'll be able to stand in the same place where my father stood with his brother and decided that we're going to run into the woods.
I ran out from this back.
And maybe we'll go into those woods, maybe we'll find the bunkers.
This is where we used to go in the woods. We used to come out here, used to go in there.
So there were approximately 30,000 partisans, and they were armed resistance fighters, and they were spread out all throughout Europe. There were Jews that fought back, and they sabotaged the Germans, they destroyed thousands of trains and convoys, but the most important thing that they did, they saved lives, thousands of lives. Which makes me, you know, really proud of my grandfather and his brothers.
The war killed off hundreds of the Kartens and their close relatives.
I knew the Kartens as a child, all the brothers and their father, Harry's grandfather, your great-grandfather. My family is grateful that the Karten brothers were responsible for saving the entire community. So they saved all our lives.
I always kind of had, you know, in the back of my mind, we're going to eventually go to Poland, but I never really realized that eventually we're going to go to Poland, we're going to go to the Ukraine. I'm going to where my grandfather came from. I'm going back to my heritage. My grandfather's two brothers lived in the town of Berbica. Before it was turned into a Jewish ghetto, we used to be a part of Poland. But you know, now it's part of the Ukraine. And we, you know, we just really want to see if we can find where Jaime and Izzy lived and see if there's any trace of Jewish life here.
You see the alarm bells here? This.
So what's that?
There was two apartments. One was one brother, one was the other brother.
Uh-huh.
Top.
Well, there is a family Karten here.
Karten, no.
Karten. Karten.
No, Karten.
Looks terrible. So you see the building over
That's
there.
That's the synagogue where the
yeah,
dump is?
Yeah, this is the synagogue, right.
Ah.
This is the synagogue, the 16th century building. It originates from the 16th century, since the times when Jews settled here.
Wow.
Reduced to dumps. No one cares for it. During the Soviet times, the synagogue was turned into a cannery, making the canned vegetables and things like that. Now it's just a ruin.
And there was a Jewish town here, half Jewish at least, or more. It's just not Jewish anymore. There's very few Jews left here.
My dad's getting a little bit frustrated because we can't find anyone who knows our family yet. So we're gonna go off to Schwirsch, my grandfather's hometown, to see if there's anyone there.
My father was Israel Karten. My grandfather was Moshe Karten. Moshe had the mill.
Moshe had the mill.
Wow.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. Remember her?
Ah, цю жінку пам'ятаєте?
Маришка.
Маришка.
Uh-huh.
I remember her.
She knew my great-grandfather, Moshe. I am so glad we came here. I really am.
And some Ukrainian and Ukrainian boys were running around and shouting, "Germans, Germans, come here! They're Jews here."
То вони їх то страшне було багато. Було багато. То було тоді як німці. І так їх туди і звідси забирали.
Guys, I brought you here to Belzec. It was not a concentration camp, it was an extermination camp. This is where probably more than 100 relatives of ours were brought here to be killed. Rosa was my mother's older sister.
There it is.
Here. Rosa.
Right.
She was 18 years old when she was taken here and killed. My father, first with his brother Hersh, went into the woods. He left behind him four brothers and a sister and his father. And those who were left behind were taken into the ghetto of Berbica and put them on transports to bring them here. And it happened that Itchy and Jaime were both out looking for food or something. When they came back, the transport already left with their families, with their wives and their children.
If Hitler wouldn't have killed them, they would have been people. They would have still had the same lives that you see on video.
The same culture.
The home videos.
Right. And they would have had children and grandchildren.
My cousins. Your uncle.
This is... No, this is not sad. This is the life before.
Sad. Look. It's sad because these exact people were in the ghettos. These exact people were on the walls back there.
I don't know. You had a normal life.
But Hitler didn't succeed. Why?
They were partisans.
My father, your grandfather, is he?
Saved 400
and his brothers
people.
Saved 400 people.
It's just one of those things that you just have to do. It's hard to explain. I don't want to come with any expectations. I didn't realize that I was, you know, walking into the gas chambers where many, many people had died. So I didn't really want to walk in. And then I said, no, I have to, you know, I had to witness this for myself.
People realize that they're not here for showers, they were here for death.
I look to my left and I see a shower ducts. And I look up and I see scratches on the wall. And I it was overwhelming. It was very, very overwhelming. I wanted to come in here, you know, play it strong, you know, I want to be fine. It's not gonna faze me. I'm gonna act tough for my dad, act tough for my brother, but it's an emotional experience I don't really feel before. I broke down.
Amen.
You know, you cry a lot of times in your life. You cry when you're sad, you cry when you're happy. There are different types of, you know, emotions that you go through. But when you cry over a people, you know, a nation, your people, your nation that was murdered, that's something completely different.
What did these children do wrong if the Germans had to kill them? It's just not fair. You don't know until you have children.
It's all so real. Here, imagine everybody had a family. They could have had, I have many cousins, they could have had so many cousins, and each and every one could have had a lot of family. Kate, Cap, Kaplan.
Karten.
Here.
All of these Kartens, haven't we? Wow.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Karten Branislav, Karten Busha, Karten Bluma.
This is all Poland, this is Bielsa.
Yeah, Karten Dvora. That's my grandmother right there.
I feel that my grandparents were luckier, or I guess made their own luck and ran out to the woods. But my grandfather returned to not to the concentration camps, but to the ghetto around the woods, and returned back and forth, collecting as many Jews as possible from the ghetto. So I'm just thinking, like, my grandfather must have seen this many times and then ran away, and then I guess had the balls to run back again. I mean, you escape a camp like this, you don't want to ever see it again. He came back and he brought more people there. Brought them with him. That saves their life.
You guys remember the Partisans song? The one Grandpa used to sing with the Partisans in the forest? Let's give it a try now.
The first word is Zog. Zog nicht is don't say.
Zog nicht keimel as. The geist.
Sog nicht keinmal als der Geist, der Arm lässt ihn weg.
Kommen wird noch in unser ausgebenten Scher.
Sure.
Der Vater Poiket und unser Trometen Seiden.
Zenendu.
Zenendu.
That's not so bad, you know? That was pretty good.
Das Lied geschrieben ist mit Blut und nicht mit Blei. Es ist nicht kein Liedl von einem Vogel läuft er frei. Das hat ein Volk zwischen Fahlen dick gewendet. Das Lied gesungen mit einer Garnes in die Hände. Das hat ein Volk zwischen Fahlen dick gewendet. Das Lied gesungen mit einer Garnes in die Hände.
The building is a flour mill that your great-grandfather owned, Moshe Karten, and he used to produce flour for the community.
you look in this window, people have put their clothes, something in there now.
But check this out, Dad.
What?
It's like nobody ever touched it for like 40, 50 years. It's crazy.
You know what's so special about this flour mill? It's not only that like your great-grandfather built it with his own hands, but if you look anywhere, Poland and Schwierz, things have been moved, things have been touched. This hasn't been touched. That's what I like about this place so much.
My grandfather was an Orthodox Jew, and he didn't become a rabbi, although his mother wanted him to. But he did become the head of the Jewish community, and he brought up his children Orthodox. My father tried to pull away a little bit from that. He would read books that his father was not fond of him reading, that type of thing, but basically, it was still an Orthodox way of life.
This is the area that used to be the Jewish cemetery.
My grandfather built a grave for his mother. It had to be unmarked, though, because there was anti-Semitism at the time. So instead of a big memorial thing, they just they carved in Delta Kappa for Devorah Karten. And afterwards, they planted four trees to memorialize it.
The Holocaust affected the way I am, my personality. I think it has, you know, it takes a role in all of our lives. When you see someone hurting or you see someone in pain, you go over them immediately, instinctively.
That's what makes me think about Sudan or Darfur or Rwanda. I mean, the same things are happening there, and it's slightly differently, but they're still happening. I think it's our responsibility to go and stop that, because we inherently have to stop these types of atrocities. It's not just my responsibility, but it's any person's responsibility. As a member of the human society, as being a human being, inherently one must consciously continually try to stop these atrocities from happening ever again.
Looking in the back of where Dad's house was, he was standing over here, he explained, looking down into the fields with his brother Hersh. He says, we don't want to go into the ghettos. We want to survive, and we're going to run into the woods, and we'll find a place how to live there through the winter. He didn't know it would be three winters, but at that time. We ran through, and they went and went and went all the way to the forestry in the back there.
I think I'd like to sit down on a bench and look at this view with Grandpa and just not say anything to each other.
No, kind of I would have a huge... Grandpa was here.
Just like to sit down on a bench and just look out at the view, just sit for a while with tea. That's all. No, I don't even have to speak to him. Just to sit next to him, that would be enough.
If Grandpa was here, I would sit with him. He would explain to me all the family that he lost, all the family that he still has, all the risks he took.
I think he'd like you best.
I mean, I'm named after him.
Like, that means something.
So we're gonna go into the forest to try to find this man named Michael. And apparently his family helped my family in the forest, supplying them with information, food, you name it. And, you know, we're gonna talk to him. Maybe he knows a little bit more about where the bunkers are.
Yes, this is the man.
Ви, можливо, його пам'ятаєте.
I recognize him. How are you?
Як ваші справи?
Michal, it was people like your father, your family that helped with supplies for them to survive. And it's because of families like yours that we are alive today. From here is supposed to be 3 kilometers inside.
Тобто оцей табір, де вони переховалися у війну, десь 3 кілометри звідси.
Правильно?
Correct. А можна до неї перейтися?
Так. Можна, то недалеко.
Let's go. Ви це знайшли у цих бункерах, де ми були, так? Yeah, that's where he found it. Improvised stove for living in the forest.
But it's proof, it's evidence, you know?
If you can please keep the oven intact so that when I come back, I can show my kids the oven.
No,
sure.
This forest is meaningful to me. This is the forest where the Jewish people hid. They fought here. They gathered, they hunted. This is where it all went down. And it's nice. It's nice to... We came all the way here from New York primarily for this. And we're here. And it's surreal. It's great.
In the beginning, the partisan group was two, my father and his brother. And then suddenly it grew into the four and then to eight and it multiplied out. Some were better with guns, some were better with cooking, some were better with tracking.
My grandfather had to run into the forest and hide. He could disappear in a matter of seconds. But there was no real way for them to get food, so they had to beg and steal from the locals.
When they were cramped in the concentration camps into the little tiny rooms, and they couldn't even see light, barely, there was still that feeling, there was a feeling of like trapped, and they knew they were gonna die soon. But my grandparents, they were here, they could see among the leaves, they could see light, and that was their sign of freedom. That's where they knew, I'm free, I'm not in these concentration camps. Since the forest was dark, and the Nazis were coming into the forest, and they already had the darkness, and you couldn't see them. They had a greater advantage. I'm sure there were times where they would gather around with all the partisans, and they would start singing partisan songs, and they would just be here, moonlight on them.
So when I was running up there, I found these logs, right? And I didn't get to check exactly what's underneath the logs, but it's looking like it's been there for a very, very long time. There's like moss on it growing and stuff like that. I kind of want to check it out. What do you guys think?
Dad, we're in here.
Come look at what your father built.
Grandpa built this. Well, do they have shovels here?
They brought whatever they had. They started with spoons.
Whoa, no way.
Yeah.
Spoons?
You had compartments. It wasn't just one round thing. You had holes in the sides. One would sleep in that one, two in there, one in there.
Wow. My grandpa did this. The hole in the ground? Wouldn't have been here, you know? The hole in the ground was man-made. And I'm like, this is where he slept. This is where his partisan group based, and it was really meaningful for me.
The entrance was on this side, on the other side. And there were four persons in this bunker. Father used to bring firewood here. And all these interactions were at night, as Father told me. You see, at night they were hidden in the bunkers and they did work at night. He remembers he was here with his father and he remembers logs placed on top of this bunker. Father told me.
His father told me all stories. It amazes me how the first time, with as much perseverance as we had, we couldn't come into the woods and find it. And now it's a success. Now I feel it, and I, you know, can sense my parents here and cooking together and eating together and singing together. It really touches me to know I can see you again, and my children will come back other times to see you also, but most of all to thank you and your family for generous hearts and good souls.
І вони ще будуть сюди приїздити і хочуть бувати тут багато разів.
And tell him to remember us and tell his kids that when we want to come back.
Zognik einmal aus gegessen letzten Weg. Koschen Lomeinen was zu stellen bei den Tag. Kommen weg nach unser Eus gewünschte Schoch. Zweiter Pott in unser Freund mit seinen Dorf. Kommen weg nach unser Eus gewünschte Schoch. Thank you.
Thank you.